Gymnastics doctor pleads guilty to sex charges. A sports doctor accused of molesting girls while working for USA Gymnastics in Michigan State University pleaded guilty Wednesday to multiple charges of sexual assault and will face at least 25 years in prison. Dr. Larry Nasser, 54, was charged with molesting seven girls, mostly under the guise of treatment at his Lansing area home and a campus clinic. All but one of his accusers was a gymnast. He faces similar charges in a neighboring county in lawsuits filed by more than 125 women and girls. Olympic gymnasts Ailey Raisman, Michaela Marini and Gabby Douglas are among the women who have publicly said they were among Nasser's victims. Some of his accusers attended the hearing Wednesday in a packed Ingham County courtroom. Some were crying. Nasser admitted to digital penetrating the victims and agreed that his conduct had no legitimate medical purpose and that he did not have the girl's consent. The plea deal in Ingham County calls for a minimum prison sentence of 25 years, but a judge could set the minimum sentence as high as 40 years. In Michigan, inmates are eligible for parole after serving a minimum sentence. Sentencing was set for January 12. The girls have testified that Nasser molested them with his hands, sometimes when a parent was present in the room, while they sought help for gymnastics injuries. He convinced these girls that this was some type of legitimate treatment, Assistant Attorney General Angela Pavlaitis told a judge last summer. Why would they question him? Why would they question this gymnastics god? Separately, Nasser is charged with similar crimes in Eaton County, the location of an elite gymnastics club. He also is awaiting sentencing in federal court on child pornography charges. The Michigan criminal cases against Nasser followed reports last year in the Indianapolis Star about how USA Gymnastics, which trains Olympians, mishandled complaints about sexual misconduct involving the doctor and coaches. Women and girls said the stories inspired them to step forward with detailed allegations of abuse, sometimes when their parents were in the exam room at Michigan State.